Hi everybody, David Dilling on behalf of Markzware here. Check this out. Just launched my new InDesign 19.4 and InDesign 2024, the new version 19.4, just out yesterday. First thing I saw, I actually knew it was in there, was text to image in beta. So let's try it out right now, because this is really exciting. This could really be truly like a real game changer in desktop publishing. So they have this little example here, and we can zoom into it. We can see here the little prompt, which we're all now used to in Photoshop and Illustrator. And we can type in, lizard and sand, just to go against the grain. I know they want a mushroom burger, but let's see what lizard and sand looks like. Will it do it? Can it do it? And look at that. It does do it. And pretty darn good as well. Lizards are always fun to take pictures of because they sort of like pose for you, you know. But these are beautiful pictures. Not that I want to eat a lizard. It shouldn't be in the menu. I know. We're going to get rid of it. So, for instance, this sales guide here, this is the Markzware sales guide. And if you're a dealer or a consultant or whatever, you can always ask for this. It's on our website and it tells you all about how you can market and sell the Markzware products for file conversion, pre-flight, etc. But maybe I want to change up the background here, right? So if I just click on that background image, change this background image, right? Instead of looking around stock sites and all that, I can just now write in Adobe InDesign, just type a prompt where I'll paste it in, graphic design office, printing press, printing artwork. It's going to be a photo or art type of generated image. In this case, we're going to go for not artsy, but photorealistic. And you can choose either to make it a certain size or fit the frame dimensions. Let's do that. And we'll hit generate. So this is truly, 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 I think, just amazing. For desktop publishers out there working in design. Bingo, I have a new background. It's royalty free as far as, I'm concerned. There are other issues with AI. We'll get to that in a second, or potential issues, But look at that, I can now choose from the different options that they give here. And maybe you don't like any of these, and maybe, that doesn't work out. You could just say, printing press, printing print work, generate that. Now what's cool, it actually changes the image in your links folder here. I kind of like that one because it text pops out a bit more. It is a bit funky, So you can go through and choose from all the different options and just keep generating till you get a prompt that actually works, right? So this is really a game changer. Now, check this out. Let's go back to this one here. And let's now make this one mushroom burger with a light colored background. And we'll generate. There we go. It kind of fits our style. If you just do mushroom burger, because I was playing with this earlier, you get more delicious looking mushroom burgers. I mean, I still need to eat breakfast. This is a little heavy. So there you get some different mushroom burgers. I kind of like this one. It kind of fits in. Look, that one's got a lot of parsley around. I kind of like the background. It's a little bit different than our other backgrounds. That's the only negative here. But hey, just for this test, let's just run with this. There's our mushroom burger. It's right up in here. We can now file, save this out. I'm going to get out of InDesign here. I'm going to open up my fly check here. And I'm going to take that InDesign file we just saved out. I'm going to drop it on fly check. Because maybe we just got this file in, pretend it's a huge file. It's a big document, important document. And now we can go through and we can say, okay, there's our mushroom burger. I mean, it doesn't even like stand out. It's another mushroom burger, right? Looks good. We can see that this is a web, intended for web, this document. We get a whole bunch of information on the file. And we can make reports and all that. Now, if we switch to pre-flight results mode, sorry, we were in pre-flight results mode, and we can also look in inventory mode and also see more information, for instance, on all the embedded images. What are you noticing about that right away? And if we're in the pre-flight mode, you see it as well. you see that generative, it says Gen AI image. Generative AI produced image is what it's telling us right there. So we're being warned, watch out, this file is using AI and AI create image. And there it is right there. No guessing, no, you know, trying to figure out. Now, if it's a person you have in there, and certain organizations don't want to use AI generated work at all because there's still a gray area legally, particularly with people because of various things. So it's very important for, depending on what the publication is, who the producer is, to check for AI. Do you need to anyway know that AI has been used and to state that if you're distributing this work in any way, shape, or form, so that people know it's an AI generated image. That might even become law to a certain degree. So this is a very, very interesting thing in flight check. One of many things you can check for in flight check in our ground controls, of course. So this is the great thing in flight check. You can choose what you want to check for, and it comes back and it gives you warnings. In this case, we can see, well, this is a normal image, you know, but this one, it's clearly a AI, generative AI created image. So very handy. For more information on Markzware's flight check, so over on Markzware.com, you can get more information on flight check down below here. And there's a full working demo you can get for 30 days. So check it out, try it out. Use it to check your documents for generative AI produced material. For instance, I mean, just to round it off here, if I take this Photoshop document and drop it on flight check, we get a little preview. But look at that. We also can see generative AI used within native Photoshop documents. So the rabbit hole is big with this AI, and flight check helps you dig down deep and see what's inside of them. So who's over to Markzware.com today, get your flight check demo, and check out InDesign 19.4 with a new text-to-image generative AI feature. Very cool. All right, everybody. Have a great day. Take care.